Hi, it's Dr. Centeno, and I'd like to go into how I look at a pre-screening for a telemedicine. And that is trying to figure out if I've got something I can offer that patient by trying to determine their type of craniocervical instability. So we've got really three different things that are shown here that are going on. The first one is this CCI type 1C, and that's really looking at, or at least one of the ways to look at it, is the depth of the C0C1 facet joint. Now, you're going to see the research paper on the screen right now that I refer back to, and that's if the patient has Chiari, the shallowness of the C0C1 facet joint predicts symptoms, meaning there's probably a 1C type instability occurring where the skull can slide because the facet joint isn't deep enough. So if we run this math, as you'll see on the screen to the right there, we've got a problem. That's a very shallow C0C1 facet joint that is associated with significant symptoms if there is Chiari. So that's a CCI type 1C. If there's Chiari, so let's go now to the second pane here. This is the MRI. It's not an upright MRI, so it's going to underestimate Chiari, but we see there that the posterior cerebellar tonsils here just touch the line drawn across the foramen magnum. And same thing here. So there is a Chiari 0 or CTE. So now this becomes significant. And then if we look at the rectus capitis posterior minor, that actually opens the door back here for CSF flow. And we see that any area within these lines that I drew here that isn't dark means that the muscle is atrophied. So there's moderate atrophy of the rectus capitis posterior minor. That's obviously associated with headaches and other problems related to decreased CSF flow in a Chiari 0 or CTE patient. And then there's a type 3A cervical instability here where C2 is going forward on C3. It's kind of right at the max of 1 to 2 millimeters for C2-3, but I think we'd call that an abnormality. So we have a type 1C, Chiari, we have atrophy of the rectus capitis posterior minor, and we can see we have a type 3A. So as you can see, there's a lot that goes into our pre-screening. There's a lot that goes into a telemedicine evaluation for patients to try to see if we can help them. This particular patient would be a candidate for a PICL procedure to address this skull sliding type CCI 1C. They would also be a candidate for treating the suboccipital nerve to help this atrophy of the rectus capitis posterior minor. And then also a candidate in addition for tightening down the ligaments back here to help this C2-3 problem. In addition, we'll probably inject the 0-1 facet joint under digital subtraction angiography, fluoro contrast conformation, probably inject those 2-3 facet joints as well. So just wanted you to see all that goes into trying to determine if someone's got craniocervical instability and if we can help. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.
You know what to do. Like, share, comment, subscribe. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.